Our first visit to Skye started with an early breakfast in Tindrum. And then I was on my way. I'm sure the view will be improved by a clean windscreen, but you can't have everything. Once over the bridge, it was time to find somewhere to park up for the night. And I went down into Glenbrittle and found a lovely little spot by the river and settled down for the evening. So my first night on Skye. I've never been anywhere quite as dark as it was in here last night. A riverside park up, and just within those trees is a car park to wander over to the fairy pools. That's where we're going to go today. Now let's get going. Well, there's the car park, the fairy pools, and the glorious sunshine from where I've just been parked up for a night. I wonder, right inside the river, and I'm going to close the fairy pools. I'm walking to the only big black cloud in the sky right now. After leaving the fairy pools, it was time to find somewhere to park up for the night. This looks good enough. And I'm still working on my photography skills. But did capture some night sky. Good morning from Skye. And this is where I parked up last night. And a little spit of land at the far side of the van there is where we're going now. I'm going to visit the lookout buffet at Rubnahoonish. Of course I'm wearing my NBA hat. Why wouldn't you? This track has got slip on your arse all over it. So I'm going to turn you off and keep myself upright. There doesn't appear to be anyone in the main room, so I might have a place to myself. And there's a bench. Not a bad view is there, is it? Hey, been wanting to come here for years. Met it. Main room with the lucky bothy, nice and tidy. Looks like we just started a new bothy book as well. Only a couple of pages of stuff in there. Not bad views out there, is it? It's all tidy in here. I'll look at the rest of it. So the kitchen area. And the bedroom. Good for three, maybe more if you're very friendly. I'm going to plonk myself down, enjoy the views, and I'll probably wander out to the bench and sit out there for a bit as well. Until next time. Spectacular, isn't it? This is going to be my perch for the next 10 minutes or so. And to look out over Lewis from this bench was well worth the walk. There's a little boat that's come from those islands. Kind of looks like it's coming back to the mainland somewhere. Lewis is looking quite splendid. I have to go over there sometime. Let's wander back to the van. Bye bye. Well, as we get back to the van, the red phone box comes into view. And the rain's on. There's not a great deal of wind, so I would imagine this rain's in for a day. The glasses are all stained up and I'm getting wet. It's time to change of clothes and find somewhere to park up for the night. So from a soggy sky, I'll love you and leave you for now. Bye bye.
when I parked up yesterday, it was pretty cloudy on this view. I'm fairly certain that's the old man I'm going to wander up to today. It's pretty impressive, isn't it? The sun's coming up. GoPro on the roof of the van, hoping to catch a good sunrise.
As you'll see, the top of the van is dirtier than the windscreen. It's time to head off up the store. Right, well, all wrapped up. It's not too cold, but it is very windy. So I would imagine it's going to get colder the higher up we go. Right, let's crack on. Enough chopper action for now. They're pretty good views, aren't they? We're right up there now, between all the bags full of rocks. Around the back of the old man. It looks a different thing from every angle. Yeah, past a bit of an ankle breaker, so there'll not be so much of this going on. And it's actually cold now, so yay for the wind. Right, I'll put you back away, and I'll see you later. And walking beneath the pinnacle of the Old Man of Stow, it certainly does feel like it's much larger than its 164 feet. Go on then, one more view from the other side. There's a slight lull in the breeze as well then. Right. Okay, on the way down now. And it's impressive behind me, but I'd say it's spectacular in front of me. Due some rain in a couple of hours' time. Another coastal park up was followed by a soggy day in Portree before a stop in Glencore to break up the journey home. Thanks for watching. I'll be going back to Skye. I really enjoyed the place.